Okay, so you've tweeted yesterday that Hansel Mehta, this is a mindfuck you and Kangana put me through on Simran, which led me to a breakdown. If you had the courage to stand up then, we could have weathered many more storms together. I salute Krish's courage and goodness, especially when he talks of his team. And you've said catharsis. I believe you also had a paralytic attack last year.
You know, coincidentally, at the same time when Mr. Kamal Jain, who it happened now in mid-January, Kamal Jain, I think he had a paralytic stroke. I had a paralytic attack, a neurological attack, basically, where the right side of my face got completely paralyzed. This happened on January 15, the same time last year, just as we had come out of Simran. I think Simran released in September. And 2-3 months after that, I had this attack. So I was in the same hospital. It was an extremely trying time for me because I tried to understand what. I mean, there's a lot of stress, you know, and a very big star is going to town, beating, you know, all the big publications and all the big TV channels against you. How do you fight that? How do you fight? When your entire career, you've tried to be honest, you've tried to be good, you've given your best. You know, you've built a reputation, you know, and a clean reputation. And then suddenly, you know, somebody comes in and, goes to town like that. It took a very big toll on me. I mean, more than that, what she did, and I know, and I will be able to understand that after this, after Krish has spoken up, you know, I will put this to rest because, people cannot question that anymore. But what really got to me was the fact that my closest friends and my closest collaborators, Hansel, sat silently throughout this thing. And one thing is saying that, you know, one doesn't want to sabotage one's film by bringing negativity into it. But, you know, you're allowing her to do the very same thing. You're allowing her to go out there. And you're allowing her to say, this one didn't write the film, this didn't happen, we threw him out. That is negativity. So the controversy is happening, but you decided to stay on her side and make it look like she was telling the truth. You sat next to her while she was saying these horrible things about me and you nodded. You allowed your son and your producer to go to press saying things that I had not done Aligarh, I had not done Shahid. You got a writer from an old film of mine, a co-writer, to come in and say that I tried to take away his credit when you yourself have gone on record saying you wanted to give me the credit because I had done the work, the job of the screenplay. I had never even claimed that I had done these things. So I went through a lot and it was a very lonely battle because people in the industry are afraid to stand up and speak up. You know, but I fought that and it took its toll on me, you know. So I had a very similar attack in, and I still haven't fully recovered, Faridun. And even now her trolls say to me about karma, see, you got your karma for messing with her, and they say horrible things to me, you know. First of all, you have to experience that and you fight that battle, okay, and then they taunt you about it. It takes its toll, you know, and of course it's something that has made me much stronger. But to see the man, he's still in hospital while all this is going on.
But yeah? there is an entire mystery because there are people who are saying that he's back home and he's fine. So there's a mystery.
Maybe he's back now. But during this whole period, while all this the release was going on, he was on ventilator.
But
you know,
there are media reports that he is still in the hospital. So there's a bit of a confusion.
Yeah, but I mean, I think she herself has said that he had some neurological problem in the brain and suffered a stroke, so a paralytic stroke. So, I mean, it's like, it's out there now. And I feel terrible. And I've never blamed her for this. I blame stress for these things. A person has, it's your own internal makeup whether you can deal with stress or not, right? Maybe mine wasn't strong enough. I won't blame. You know, do you know what happened after this? There were so many people who started writing to me. Somebody has done black magic on you, do some puja. My mom started to go ballistic. She started to believe that somebody has done a jadu tona on me. And then she started to do pujas and all that nonsense. You know, and I turned around and I told her, I said, you know what? If your mind is strong, nobody can influence that. Nobody has the power to be able to externally do something if your mind is strong. Maybe my mind was weak. Maybe I was too vulnerable. Maybe I believed in people too much.
Right.
You know, too easily. You know, so I just feel like it's unfair to blame anyone even for this, for what's happened with Kamal Jain in the hospital. But I know that continued stress takes its toll on you. You know, and Yeah, in our industry it happens a lot.
Hansal Mehta has tweeted yesterday, he has posted and he said that I chose to remain silent before the film release, that is Simran, because there was no way I could sabotage a film that had the efforts of so many people at stake. I chose to remain silent after the release because I was relieved that the film was finally out and I did not want to relive what I had endured. I had to move on for my own sanity. Have you forgiven him now?
I don't know if I've forgiven him. I don't know if it's just hurt that I'm unable to deal with. But I just kind of came to the realization that everybody doesn't have the courage, like say a Krish does. You know, Krish could have taken the same stand. But all the people who work with him and his team, they must have a lot of respect right now for him and must feel a little bit supported. He spoke very highly of every member of his team. You know, he owes it to them. As a captain of a ship, when you hire a team and you inspire them to give your all for a film, no matter what you go through personally, you are still responsible for that team. And if you make it about yourself, oh, I went through this, you know, no, not at all. You know, if you can see that there's a person who's harming your film, there is a person who is completely undermining your job and the job of every department, and you cannot stand up to her. At the same time, you allow her to continue doing what she's doing. You're supporting the hijacking of your film. You're supporting the negativity. You are part of it then. Like they say, you know, when you watch Injustice, if you just sit quietly, you are part of the problem. And I always saw him as someone who stood up against injustice. So that was a betrayal that I felt. But today, I mean, yeah, I forgive him. I just have to put it down to the fact that today, now that I stand vindicated, you know, I don't expect anything from him anymore. I don't want a sorry. I don't want a thank you. I don't want nothing. You know, just let him live his life and have his peace. And let Kangana and him go their own ways. I want nothing to do with them anymore, ever again.
All right. Thank you so much, Apurva. It was lovely talking to you. And you have a great time. And all the best wishes. And looking forward to seeing you in the movies very soon.
Yeah. Now the good stuff will come. I'll keep you posted.
Fantastic. Okay.